the kicking team will come along with Ryan Succop.
Dog, is it still like 90 degrees
though?
Yeah,
there though? Was a time you wouldn't even give this a second thought as far as whether you kick the field goal.
All right, gotta go back outside.
It's changed so much with analytics that now...
Where are you going?
I'm installing seat covers, dog.
They're just as likely to go for it in these situations as they are to settle for three.
Wait, Joe Flacco and Ryan Fitzpatrick are both FCS former players?
And he bends it in. 50 yards.
Delaware and Harvard.
31-10. Tampa Bay.
Are you watching that game, Tony? Or
nice
just
draw to it.
Ah.
And the Bucs add to their advantage here early second half.
Neither game is very good.
We met over a century ago, this country and this company. We've seen tough times, but we've learned we're better when we come together.
It's all Brian Flores and
it's magic. A family-led business with 260,000 people working together at plants and offices and dealerships across
the Red Sox are coming off a win in their previous game.
More U.S. hourly
Hi, good everybody.
Yeah.
I'm Dwayne Kuiper with former 20-game winner Mike Shurko for EA Sports MVP
Miles
Baseball.
Miles been pretty good.
Starting on the hill for the home team, Bronson Arroyo. Build for the
future. Maybe. And Van Gogh was there last year
the
for sure.
Oh, well, Michael. Angels and the Boston Red Sox.
This country and this company. Now we build for every single American.
So Roger Piran actually retired?
We were built in America.
I didn't know that. Remember we were talking about the Giants and Redskins?
Thank you. Bradley, get a freshly made Subway.
And the Redskins had a chance to tie the game.
Try my favorite turkey.
I don't know if they went for two or missed the extra point. I'm going to guess they went for two and didn't get it.
Try the new Subway Buffalo Chicken or Barbecue Chicken.
Towards third base. Who painting your wall?
I don't either. No one does.
Helped your team win?
2-point pass conversion failed.
Of course it won. Why would you even ask that?
That's brutal. He painted the black with that one.
Not too hot to be uncomfortable. Just a I'm a Verizon engineer.
This is a bad way to lose a shitty neural patch.
5G across the country with a coverage of 5G nationwide. And in more and more cities, the unprecedented performance of ultra-wideband. The fastest 5G in the world.
Let's be honest here, if this is 2007, Harvick would have just won that race.
I'm proud, because we didn't build it the easy way.
Not 2007 anymore. Right. Or 2007, Mark Martin would have won that race.
Only from Verizon.
Big Ten football returns. Oh no, because I don't think Mark was in the car in the 07 Kansas race. I think that was,
Freedom Smith. Dang.
Yeah. Today's game is sponsored by. People forget he shared the 01 with Smith, but in a way,
before he shared the 8 with Almirola.
Right.
Tampa, Florida, home of the Tampa Bay Buccaneers.
Fortunately, he never had to share the 6 with Wally Dallenbach or Ted Musgrave.
Yeah, thank Christ.
Ryan Succop. As Buck and now Pinion drives it out of the back of the end zone. And it's 1-2. Talked about that turning point. Here it is.
Ooh,
10-0 Green Bay
Flacco
in total control.
No, he's getting up.
On their half of the 50, and this pick six, Jamel Dean took it down the sideline and in. And then a couple of throws later, this ball knocked up into the air and picked off by Mike Edwards. Taken into the end zone by Ronald Jones.
I'm just surprised NBCSN didn't bump it off to stream only for like cricket or something stupid.
Possession of the second half for Green Bay. Just one first down over their last five possessions in that first half. Toss to Jones. On first down, a gain of 4. Devin White on the stop.
Yeah, so the defense, Joe, off of those plays allows Tampa then to take
a British Premier League training.
Right, and yet the defensive play ignited their offense.
What you're saying is not a good race.
David Bakhtiari.
I know it was a great race, but the problem was is just when you were in second, you just couldn't get to the leader.
Because Zach is making it sound like it's the worst race ever.
To him and I'm assuming he only watched it through the lens of only NBCSN, which if you watched it through that, then yes. Their coverage is so Christ-awful, half the race was using onboard cameras.
Now we gotta hear about Kevin, how he watched on like four different streams. So he could watch.
Which is why every time I watch, I got the battle cam from NASCAR driving a couple other onboards.
So you got like, you got like four streams open for it?
No basically.
State Farm just has surprisingly great rates.
Yes, actually.
I know you don't offer it to just anyone.
MRN's good.
We do. I can't stand listening to Rick Allen's idiocy.
Our little secrets.
Yep.
Oh. Like, I did tune it to NBC for the final 10 laps because my MRN stream kept jumping from being either right on time or a lap ahead. I don't know why that happened.
Great to see Bakhtiari up and walking off. Aaron Rodgers went
over
the
10 laps just to final 10 laps just that way I was, you know, on the same page. I just listened to, wanted to gouge my ears out.
Yep.
At the end of that play, he tripped over John Lovett.
Well, I get that the radio guys can be like, I don't know.
A little extra.
Yeah, a little extra.
Yeah, they get a little excited over nothing, but it's better than Rick Allen talking nonsense and them going, "All right, let's hope the Rutledge Wood and see what the fuck bullshit he has."
He's an 18 All-Pro, two-time Pro Bowler, and one of the best in the game. Well, they bring in Rick Wagner, number 71. He now comes in to man that left tackle spot. He's filling some awfully big shoes. And he has got JPP across from him.
That was a pretty good play. I was asking
for a good here to Jones and JPP in the tackle. First to hit Jones. And then it's the replacement for Vita Vea, Raheem Nunez Rochus.
Oh, that's not him. That's Breida.
He's also got big shoes to fill. Vita Vea, who broke his right leg in the last game against.
Travis Kelce and Zane Gonzalez, or Michael Gallup, George Kittle, and Nicole Hardman. George Kittle.
It's a significant loss, but they haven't felt that. So they give up one big run to Jamal Williams in the first half, 25 yards. Other than that, they've been ironclad. They're down in five. Rodgers' pass is nearly picked. Stepping in front of it was Antoine Winfield Jr. The target was Tanyan. And Sue and Rodgers talking again.
They're still going at it. And Tanyan, he kind of is pulling up. He's going to get into this hole, and he's expecting the ball to be thrown, you know, in that area, and Rodgers is leading him. He's just extremely fortunate that Winfield does not intercept this ball. That's you won't see Winfield miss.
I didn't know that Fournette was out today.
The punt by Scott.
Huh?
Oh
yeah. For last year. But last week, Fournette was active but didn't play at all.
And Antoine Winfield Jr. almost had his
this
first
week he's inactive.
The
Maybe they need a roster spot so they could call up Chris Bryant.
Sean before dawn trains at 6 because breakfast is at 0700 sharp. BGT Esquire needs to try out these brand new leggings. I need cake loves. Cake. We have our own reasons, but we all showed up for each other.
There are thousands of you here today. Let's make the most of it.
Arroyo throws it over for a shot.
Well, things are different these days, but we're figuring it out. We're doing school online now, learning a lot. Finding cool stuff to watch. Dad's got some new workout buddies. And I still get to spend time with you.
Hola, soy J Balvin, and I'm dropping my McDonald's order. Let go. Hey, Big Mac, meal and fries, and I know you're McFlurry. There you go. The J Balvin meal. Get it on the McDonald's app, and the McFlurry is on me. I'm loving it.
Arroyo, give the call.
strike with the fastball.
Bud Light Seltzer, 5-step filtration for great taste.
T-Mobile is the leader in 5G coverage. Introducing iPhone 12 Pro with 5G. The most amazing iPhone ever meets America's largest 5G network. Now more people can download and upload at 5G speed in more places. For $100, get two iPhone 12 Pros and two new lines with unlimited 5G data included.
Ronald Acuña Jr. leads the Braves against Mookie Betts and the Dodgers. The NLCS, Game 7, tonight after football.
Today's game is sponsored by Progressive Insurance. Save when you bundle auto, home, or motorcycle insurance.
Earlier today, the Bears won at Carolina. They're now 5-1. Green Bay,
okay, against right-handed
one of the undefeateds, but trailing here now. Bakhtiari walks off. With the Packers down by 21. Buccaneers have scored on four straight drives. Brady keeps, airs it out. Contact. No flag. As Miller gets up, stunned that Adrian Amos is not called for interference.
Yeah, there definitely was contact. I want another look at this and to see exactly when Amos got to him. He kind of cut him off. I don't necessarily disagree with no flag there. He's trying to get to the position. He's not running through the receiver. I'm okay with that, but Amos, more importantly, he's got to make that play. I mean, right now, it seems like it's up to this defense, particularly right here. Darius Smith, he's the guy who single-handedly can take over a ball game, and boy, they need him to now.
Second and 10, pass is incomplete for Evans. Third down.
He breaks the table, four-seam fastball, a changeup.
Big third down, they finally got to Brady. Had two hits on him in the first half.
Got him with
they
the
got to him there. Now third and 10. Tampa was good on this down in the first this half. They were 4-7. But now would be a good time for them to make a stop. More importantly, it'd be a good time for them to create a takeaway.
The catcher set a target on the corner. The pitcher just hammered it for a strike.
No takeaways in the game so far. Just three on the year, by the way. Through four games for the Green Bay defense.
It's tied at 2-2.
He'll now face the top of the order.
Brady throws. Pass is incomplete. Godwin, the target.
Jammed him with that pitch.
And it's 3-and-out.
Good job there by Jandon Sullivan. He's typically an inside player, and he's out there on Chris Godwin. And
the pitch is,
you know, third and 10, and you're one-on-one. It was just him, mano a mano, and does a good job, forces the punt.
Darius Shepherd waits for the punt.
He pulls a ground ball to the left side. Two out.
That's the first 3-and-out for the Bucs since their first possession of the game. Green Bay needed that.
Liner right after shortstop.
And Shepherd hauls it in inside the 25.
Next up,
Big Ten football returns Saturday as Justin Fields and the fifth-ranked Buckeyes take on Nebraska. It all starts with a special big noon kickoff show live from the Shoe, only on Fox and the Fox Sports app.
Hey, look at this game, Joe, and the Packers, they really just have not been able to get the ball down the field. Their largest completion, Aaron Rodgers' longest completion is just 20 yards to Aaron Jones.
That's a good change.
I know Todd Bowles coming in knows that that's a real threat when you play the Packers and Rodgers. He's attempted it a couple times, but this secondary has done a nice job of mixing it up and not giving up any big plays.
Rodgers is sacked. David was back there with JPP.
Well, they run a little game with JPP. He's going to rush inside, and then Levante David comes around. Aaron Jones sees that late. I mean, it, take your pick. One or the other is going to make the play. They both sandwich Aaron Rodgers. I mean, I was saying it earlier, the protection for Rodgers for the first 4 weeks was as good as anybody's in the league. And today, this Tampa defense has really gotten after him.
third sack.
Fastball for a strike.
And the Bucks defense begging for a flag
to delay the game.
Offense, number 12.
Every time he gets out,
5 yard penalty. Second down.
Gathers it in with his glove.
That will back him up even more. Give us more information, Aaron, on the left tackle for the Packers.
Yeah, that third sack coming when David Bakhtiari is in the locker room. He's questionable to return with a chest injury. He was in the blue tent for a while, but they decided to take him back, Joe.
That delay of game on Rodgers, you can see the look on his face. That's on the quarterback. And what it tells you is that Rodgers, he's just not as sharp. He's just not doing the little things like you expect from him. Here is a juggle and a catch.
Not as huge as his 3rd and 18.
Just five.
Nah, this isn't huge.
Garbage.
Whoa!
Delay a game that he was a little embarrassed that he didn't realize that where the play clock was and the clock was running down. And he's not been the same guy since those two interceptions. Now it's just a question of can they give him time? Right now, are they going to come out some kind of screen play? Because so far, they've not shown an ability to protect him long enough to get the necessary depth to the receivers for the first down. Four-man rush. Rodgers steps up and throws, finds a receiver, and that's Adams. Let's see where they put it. They're going to put it right at the marker. That was beautifully done. 18 yards. And a first down. Ooh.
He got right to the sticks. He gets in behind the linebackers, and then he finds the window. You know, he just sits tight knowing that he didn't need to go anywhere. It was a matter of whether or not Rodgers was going to be able to find him. But the smart thing that Davante Adams did was knowing exactly where he had to get to, where the landmark was, in order to catch it and get the first down.
We get the feeling that could be a big completion. 18 yards on third down and 18. A little bit of life out to their 34.
Who's the Jets' backup quarterback?
Jones is hurdling players and out to the 41.
I'll look it up.
Well, that would certainly help if they are.
Why is Flacco injured?
Some positive yardage out of this running game.
I was wondering in case he gets benched.
So they're not so reliant on Aaron Rodgers.
It's magic just
to
pick off.
It really taxes this offensive line when you're not able to get any kind of run game going. And there's a tendency. I mean, here in this game,
apparently
he
doesn't. Yeah, if it's
Fitzpatrick
just got picked up. Apparently, he doesn't think that. He thinks that he stepped out of bounds.
Feeling like the game's getting away from you.
Because he's like dancing down the sideline. What? What?
Rodgers.
Watch profanity, buddy. Wow, dog. Look at this pick in the Dolphins game. If you got it on,
I don't have it on, dog.
Either way,
look, the guy caught it behind his back.
Short with the injury, what? And it's a wrist injury for Tyler Irvin.
Hold on.
Which is something that this offense with Matt LaFleur
24 to 0.
Like,
I've never seen a catch like
that
in my life.
Is them really run the play clock down and be pretty stagnant prior to the snap.
No, it's a good
that
point.
One guy almost knocked it back out. He's
a lot of shifts, a lot of different personnel.
I'm letting me go back and see it.
They're showing replays right now.
A lot of those move things you're talking about. Yeah, it has been a different look from what we had seen.
Blitz coming. Third down and 3. Pass is caught. Adams spins out of bounds with a first down.
Swing and a miss.
Well, that's big in order to be able to convert a couple of these third downs, the third and long that we saw a moment ago to Davante Adams. Now they're starting to push it a little bit. I thought after that first down they'd go even a little bit more up tempo, get Tampa a little on their heels.
This is a drop.
They're making their own breaks.
By Equanimeous St. Brown.
That was a good base running there to go from first to third in the same.
So Rodgers has looked his way a couple of times and has nothing to show for it.
No, and it was kind of a little different design, and that was more of a wide receiver type screen with him running that
here
out route. It's the same out route that he ran in that first quarter that they didn't hit on.
I just got to do right now is drive that ball to the outfield.
Now second and 10.
This one out to shallow left. What a catch.
Handoff here and a cutback to Williams.
Just like that's going to be butt fumble. This is the butt interception.
Oh, that was a great interception.
He was showing his ass on that.
A lot of games, you know, they call them blitzes, but they're really more run blitzes, and they're just going to fill every lane, and they're going to create a wall and just not give the runner anywhere to go. I mean, they are relentless in their pursuit, and these guys are flying around. So a lot of times, what you think is a blitz, it's really more of a run blitz than it is thinking that they're going to throw the football and just smother the running back. Packers have just 58 rush yards, 25 of which came on one play. They're one-on-one here. That's Adams. That is Rodgers, and the pass out of bounds.
Yeah, I was wondering if he got in.
Out there working against Carlton Davis, and it's fourth down.
That's that back shoulder fade. Sometimes you try to make a hit or chase your pitch. They're just a little off, you know. Just a little off.
Doug, is this my in Miami?
Either. I mean, that was a good throw, and that's one that we've seen Davante Adams over the years. I mean, him knowing exactly where he is on that boundary and getting his feet in, and you know, maybe that is, you know, more indicative of the last two games off. Another punt from J.K. Scott. Bucks almost got to him, and that's out of bounds. We'll see where they put it. 5.5 to go in quarter number three. And the player is down for Green Bay. That's Chris Barnes. Just a 38-yard punt on America's Game of the Week. And Rodgers and the Packers offense just off here in week six.
Let's go, come on, huddle up.
Run one way and go the other way.
He reaches with a hitting is as much middle as it is.
What if there was a membership that gave us more time to play, cheer, and celebrate together?
Guys, we have made to pay.
Okay, come on, y'all, come on.
Come on, horse.
Guys.
Hey.
Oh, he's got it!
This is the way.
We do it every night.
Like clockwork.
Do it. Run your dishwasher with Cascade Platinum and save water. Did you know certified dishwashers use less than 4 gallons per cycle, while a running sink uses that every 2 minutes? So do it with Cascade, the surprising way to save water.
There's still a few things Americans can agree on. The importance of speed, hard work, and the great outdoors. So we built a future for each of them. We electrified the Mustang and engineered it to get from 0 to 60 in under 4 seconds. Put a hybrid engine in the all-new F-150 that works as hard as it does smart. Then reimagine the Bronco as an off-roading, high-performance wild animal. This is the future we're building, and we're building it today.
The Angels have summoned
up. Here we go. This for the game. Here's a step. Stepping in. Looking. End zone. Touchdown.
Take a water break and moderate your drinking on game day.
Look at you. No braces. All the internet you can handle.
I wasn't so lucky.
The pitchers hit to left field.
Invis is not your parents' braces. Invis is predictable. Less painful, more comfortable. Invisalign.
The pan. The myth, the legend, the comfort food that started it all. The original pan from Pizza Hut for just $10.99. No one outpizzas the Hut.
31-10.
Pitcher's behind the count, so he has to come over.
Tampa Bay gets the ball back. They've basically, Troy, been mistake-free. No turnovers, no sacks, only one penalty, and that was in an offsetting situation, so nothing marked off against him. That was the big story in that loss. As Jones carries here, the loss at the Bears, 11 penalties, over 100 yards of penalties, a big reason why they lost that game. It is a different story here at home.
Yeah, and I do think this, though, Joe, right now in this ball game, you're talking 5 minutes to play in the third quarter. If Tampa Bay is going to be the team that they want to be and be a championship team, right now is the time of the game where this offensive line has to take over. I mean, Ronald Jones really has not run the ball particularly well. He hadn't had anywhere to go. There was nowhere to go there on first down. And this is a defense that had been giving up just under 5 yards a carry coming into this game.
Jones at 3.3 a carry. Here's one for Gronk. And a beautiful grab by Rob Gronkowski, dropped in perfectly by Brady for 18 yards.
This is unbelievable by Tom Brady. The route, you got Gronkowski, he ran this earlier and it was a perfect throw by Brady coming across the field from the other side. This throw right here, that's as good as it gets. And to see Gronkowski as involved in the offense as he's been today, that's been nice to see. I know Tom Brady's loving that.
Here's Jones, cuts back, big run. Ronald Jones lowers his shoulder. Got a great block from Gronkowski, who just made that 18-yard grab. And this one for Jones for 25 yards. As Brady is completing balls in this game at 74% on top of it.
They're trying to get Adrian Amos up here to be the extra guy, and the extra guy doesn't mean much if he doesn't make the play. And so even if
Shady
you're coming
McCoy.
Up, you're saying, well, we've got an unblocked guy, a lot of offenses will say we can't run the football because we've got an unblocked guy. If we ran our offense in Dallas that way,
that's,
Emmitt Smith would
apparently that's
be
who they had asked for this week when they didn't have Fournette out there.
Can the unblocked guy make the tackle? And if that's not the case, you can run the ball all day. And that was a good job. That's what they really need to get going to be able to seal games and not have to rely on Brady the entire time.
Here is
he's been pretty good.
And he got hit in the backfield by Adams. Montavious Adams got through and he made a play when the Packers needed it most.
I'm not sure the Chiefs need Le'Veon Bell either. It's a full count. Sometimes you try to make a hit. Just a locker room distraction.
That was a heck of a play by Montavious. Adams getting right through the right guard, Alex Kappa.
Packers are playing without Tyler Lancaster, who injured his shoulder. We're told he's out. Here's McCoy dancing around. He gets a yard. Good penetration there by Adams again. And it's third and long.
This guy here is a long ball threat every time he steps in the batter's box.
James Lofton is a Hall of Famer. That's kind of cool.
Really needs a big hit from this guy right here with the runner on second. A single would do the job.
There's a close pitch call to ball.
Can he play for the Packers?
Packers need to stop. Third down and 12.
It's kind of cool.
Brady's going to air it out. Downfield. End zone. Miller. Flag.
Pack. Miss. See you.
Josh Jackson in coverage, and they throw the flag in the end zone.
Josh Jackson, he kind of gets turned around. And I
Bill Belichick?
He was expecting Miller to go on the deep route, and he just never turns and makes a play on the ball. There's contact.
The second oldest coach in the NFL history, only to
pass interference.
Romeo Crennel.
37. Foul to foul, 2 yard line. Fastball automatic. Is low for first time.
That fastball sailed way out of strikes on the batter typical ball.
So they're going to put it at the 2.
Cued off the end of the bat.
Instead of saying the foul occurred in the end zone. Second pass interference called this season on Josh Jackson.
You feel like any chance Green Bay might have had, that might have just went out.
Man, the sideline reporter for the Miami game is terrible.
Down here on the
I don't know. She's like, Le'Veon Joe Flacco and Adam Gase are having a conversation on the sideline. It's the first time all day we've seen this kind of conversation between the two on the sidelines. And then they're like, well, what was the conversation about? And she's like, I don't know, it was on the other sideline, and I had my own sideline reporter over there. I have to check with him.
That big pass interference call sets him up now at the one after that short penalty.
Yeah, we came in talking about Tampa Bay's penalties from Thursday night. They lead the league in penalties. They don't have any today.
Here's Brady and out of the reach of Gronkowski.
Pretty clean football.
Oh, you guys are getting slaughtered. Good arg, but the RIP Danny Woodheads are not.
Last Thursday night against the Bears. 11 penalties over
100 yards. What do you think, Tony?
They beat themselves. They had control of that ball game.
With Ronald Jones.
And that's a style that he's not accustomed to.
65.
Over the course of his career, the least penalized team.
My opponent's not very good today.
The least penalized team in football. He's not
he started Odell and Devontae Freeman.
Handoff here, Jones. Touchdown.
They made the play.
For Ronald Jones, his first career multiple touchdown game. He's got two carries for scores from in close.
Didn't look like
what about it now, Tony?
Green Bay. A lot of guys standing upright.
Oh, 11 points. And Travis Kelce and Zane Gonzalez. Or Michael Gallup, George Kittle, and Nicole Hardman.
This to make it 38-10.
Before it was a George Kittle. I know, that's what I'm saying. You call it the George Kittle one before this time you call it the Nicole Hardman one. Yeah.
What a day for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. They fell behind 10-0. They have scored the next 38. Ronald Jones, two touchdowns. Big day for the Bucs.
I'm never starting Aaron Rodgers over Russell Wilson again. Not that I really had a choice this week. He's at 2.8 points right now, Tony. Yes.
He swiped six bases.
At Burger King, when you order a 2 for $5, you might get a side of PS5. 2 for $5, mix and match. Buy and play game in-app for a chance to win.
Brush aside the doubters, the naysayers, the noise. Oh, and Lint. You're not ready for gray, so brush it away in 5 easy minutes. Just for men, mustache, and beard. Be the man you are, and look the part.
Experian Boost has helped millions of people. How can it help you?
Whoa! 46 points! Experian Boost helped me lower my auto payment by $63.
Holy shit, he tweeted that today!
Credit scores instantly. Yeah. Free at Experian.com/boost.
Who has lax sports? Versus right-handed
pitcher. Really? But we can't shoot commercials right now.
So Hulu put our faces on some other guy's bodies.
My God.
Take from me, deep fake Saquon Barkley.
And me, Baker Mayfield's face on not Baker Mayfield's body.
That's live sports.
Go, go, go. Steal some points from the Dolphins D. I don't have anyone on the Jets, but I need their offense to do good.
Smooth driving pays off. With Allstate, the safer you drive, the more you save. You've never been in better hands. Allstate, click or call for a quote today.
Download the Fox Super 6 app. It's free to play. Answer 6 questions by 5 p.m. Eastern this morning to win $25,000 of Terry's money.
Today's game is sponsored by Burger King. Mix and match your favorites for just $5.
Line shot the other way.
How about the Tampa Bay Lightning, 2020 Stanley Cup champions, defeated the Stars in 6 games, and congratulations to the Tampa Bay Rays. We'll all have a front row seat for the Rays in the World Series for the second time. Super Bowl 55 is headed here, and Buccaneers are trying to make sure they're 4-2 after 6 weeks of the 2020 season and right in the thick of the playoff chase. Let's send it down to Aaron Anderson.
Did the Lightning win the Tampa Bay or the Stanley Cup this year or in a different year?
Winning the cup for the second time in franchise history. We had it here in the building today.
Is this year?
Of course, you mentioned the Tampa Bay Rays. No pressure on Tom Brady and the Bucs here, but come on now. This could be a little bit of a title time. Joe, I know you spent some time with Stanley last year.
Troy,
maybe
have a parade.
One day.
Well,
I don't know.
I was planning on it this year, Aaron.
Mm-hmm.
With my
I'm not driving
stars.
30 minutes to watch a fucking
Victor
hockey game.
From the 25. Green Bay just
actually, I'm not driving 30 minutes to go stand in the fucking heat and have to wear a mask.
Aaron Jones, a loss of 3, and there is nothing going on up front for the Green Bay offensive line. Again, playing without Bakhtiari.
Well, this time, Levante David, he's up on the line of scrimmage. He comes underneath, makes a play. We've seen him. We've seen Devin White. We've seen those guys line up in a lot of different spots. And that's part of Todd Bowles' defense. Create some confusion. Now Levante David's here. But they line up a lot of different
places. Dog, I bet
places,
you didn't know this, but Todd Bowles is elite.
Trying to set up a screen for Jones. I would say that's well covered. A loss of 1.
They look like Raheem Nunez-Rochez.
Mahomes takes high for
the guy we've talked about as far as replacing Vita Vea there in the middle. There's a lot of shoving going on, a lot of talking that began at the end of that first half.
Here's the
with Ndamukong Suh. But the job that Todd Jones has done. That's the big man there, number 56. He runs that thing down. Rodgers, he's been taking some punishment here in this game. But Todd Bowles, he has held Green Bay under 200 yards now in just about three quarters of play. And this was a team that was averaging close to 450 yards a game. He's done a heck of a job getting this unit ready to go.
David Bakhtiari is officially out for the rest of the game. Aaron Rodgers is running for his life out to his left, and he's going to hop out of bounds short of a first down.
Puts it away for the out.
He picks up 8, but the punt team will come on for Green Bay on fourth down. So Vita Vea is lost, and Nunez-Rochez has filled in, and you thought, well, that's a big injury coming into a game against the Green Bay Packers, the way they like to and want to run the ball. And Tampa Bay defense has been phenomenal.
They have been.
Next gen, dog, that means next generation.
They were real confident in him. And, you know, he's a different
kind of abbreviation?
Player, obviously, but, man, they have
yes.
They have not missed a beat.
Scott punts.
There's Breeshad Perriman, then. Former Tampa Bay Buccaneer.
To the 29.
He's in there with a two-out single.
45-yard punt, 3-yard return.
Does Aaron Rodgers get benched and get me even less fantasy points?
AWS. Jamel Dean on that pick 6. He has reached 20-plus miles per hour on 2 interception returns since the beginning of last year. The most in the NFL. That's the way you used to chew up yardage in this league.
That was a long strider. That's what happens. You know, you look at this game, Joe, 38 unanswered points by Tampa Bay. Starting with that pick 6 by Jamel Dean. It's
that'll do it for the Red Sox in the sixth inning.
It's been a pretty dominant performance.
Joe Haig, an extra offensive lineman in the game. Ronald Jones gets bent over backward by Jonathan Garvin.
Today's game is brought
after
to you
a pickup
EA
of
Sports.
3.
EA Sports,
Garvin, a rookie, 7th-round pick from Miami. That's going to do it for quarter number 3. As Troy just said, 38 unanswered points put up by the Buccaneers, trying to get to 4-2 on the year and hand the Pack their first loss of the season. Fox NFL Sunday returns after this from our local Fox station.
You all right?
Time to make your disappointing breakfast your ex-fist. Because Wendy's has your new breakfast look. With a fresh cracked egg on every sandwich and crispy oven-baked bacon, you'll be telling everybody about the new breakfast you're seeing at Wendy's. Hurry in for the breakfast of your dreams today.
I like big
jeans. Itty bitty jeans. Feeling trendy, y'all, with the straight jeans. Showing off those curves because you the queen. Everyone go slay in your Old Navy jeans. Welcome to Denim America with fits for the whole fam. Only at Old Navy and OldNavy.com.
Whose voice will be a trick or a treat?
You could win $100,000.
All new I Can See Your Voice, Wednesdays on Fox, or catch up anytime on these platforms.
President Donald Trump, former Vice President Joe Biden, face off one last time, and the stakes couldn't be higher. From COVID to the economy, the key issues hang in the balance. Both candidates go head-to-head for one more showdown. It's the final round in the most consequential election of our time.
We have to go back to the core values of this country.
There's nothing we cannot do if we do it together.
Don't miss the final presidential debate Thursday on Fox News Channel. America is watching.
Hey, Tony, what you doing?
I am just reviewing
Miles Gaskin, let's get to 100 yards on the day.
Total MVP. Check it out. They got a huge offensive line.
Yeah, but what if there's an audible?
Tubi has such a deep bench of free movies and television shows, there's always a perfect play.
Tubi. Download and stream on your favorite devices.
Thursday Night Football on Fox.
Oh!
The grudge match reignites.
Stop yelling.
As Jones seeks redemption in Philly.
Why?
While Wentz and the Eagles look to return to the top of the NFC East. Giants, Eagles, Thursday Night Football on Fox, NFL Network, and streaming on Prime Video.
The corners are close to the line.
Start Saturday strong.
All picked off!
As Big Ten football returns. Nebraska, Ohio State, Saturday at noon Eastern on Fox.
Is stirring, so he just wants to come out and give the bullpen some more time.
Fourth quarter begins from the 34-yard line, and Tom Brady is faced with a second down. You see the scoring 10-0 early. Pick six, and then an avalanche of points. Bucks are having fun today and trying to keep this possession going. How about this run by Ronald Jones? Back-to-back 100-yard games, and he gets 14 here, and he's knocking on the door of 100 again.
Well, Alex Kappa, the right guard, and he just mashes.
Dang, I forgot about Doug
down
Martin.
That front and creates some lane there for Ronald Jones. And, yeah, this is what I was talking about a couple of possessions ago, that, you know, this offensive line right now, you got a defense starting to give up a little bit. We saw it on that touchdown run.
Mike Gesicki hasn't caught a pass today.
Jones on first down, brought down by Adams, a gain of four. The last time the Bucs had a back go for 100 yards in three straight games, Doug Martin back in 2015.
That's a solo. The muscle.
The Nevada Penitentiary aren't.
I think that was his nickname.
Yeah, sure.
Bill shaking his head like, yes, I hope that's his nickname.
Not good.
When I go back to the car.
Ronald Jones, Rojo.
The other problem is I don't think any of my Packers guys are even going to be in the game in the fourth quarter to get me any more points.
Move over. You've got company.
Better at least keep it close if you're going to lose this big.
I'll tell you right now. This is the best time of the game for these offensive linemen.
He got turned 5 points really and Greg Zuerlein or Ezekiel Elliott.
When you get to this point in the game, I mean, for all practical purposes, the game's over. And they're just going to run the ball and keep giving it to Ronald Jones. Just feed it to him.
Yes.
And these guys know that they're going to continue to run the football and just beat on this defensive front. These guys don't get a chance less in today's game than ever before. I mean, this is like dessert for them right now.
Here is the rookie, Keshawn Vaughn, making moves out on the edge, gets 2.5. So they get Vaughn involved for the first time, running the ball. By the way, it's just the fourth time in franchise history they've had a back go for 100 plus in three straight. If Gronk told Aaron Andrews we're going to get it going today, he didn't lie. Yeah. Every phase of the game is working for the Buccaneers on offense. Play action. Brady with all day throws and misses, up for grabs as it bangs off the helmet, I believe, off the hand and helmet of Vaughn, and it drops to the grass.
Well, they go play action. They're trying to hit. It looked like Cyril Grayson is who they, you know, he's a speedster, he's a track guy at LSU. I think that's what who was in the game over there is the lone receiver. And they were going to, but Green Bay covered it up. That's, you know, Arians, no risk it, no biscuit. Even with this lead at 28 Jackson points, he wanted a home run shot from Brady, but the Packers took it away.
The last left-handed quarterback to throw a pass and completed in the NFL is Glenn Moore before Tua. Just now,
Ellen Green was there.
Moore,
from
yeah.
The Cowboys?
Yeah, the offensive coordinator.
His time there in New England, he was pretty beat up. You know, and then that year away with from football, you know, there's a part of me that wants to say, well, he probably got rested up during that year off. But, you know, heck, he was doing WWE. And I mean, he was doing all kinds of stuff. I mean, it was probably more physical last year than it was when he was playing. But he has taken a lot of punishment through his career. And even here in the early going for Tampa Bay, he's had to deal with shoulder and knee. Still fighting through a lot of punishment.
Good start to the inning. That is some serious clutch hitting.
You hear some Bucs players saying, let it go. They dealt 25-yard punt. Tap down at the.
Actually, that was 2015.
Where Green Bay has it down. 38-10.
Last time they left, he threw a complete pass in the NFL.
Hits it out to right field.
Before that, it was 2012 with Tebow.
The Angels have someone thrown into their bullpen.
Not much.
They need to get a run right here.
Are you answering my text in person?
I am.
Yeah.
And Matt Leiner.
This is tech that helps you be there. The Nissan Altima is now offering the most tech advanced engine in its class.
Ordinary tissues burn with the old blows. So Dad bought Puffs Plus Lotion and rescued his nose. Puffs have more lotion and soothing softness to relieve. A nose in need deserves Puffs.
I'll go read the brown subreddit.
This right here is the papadilla, which if I'm not mistaken, is Latin for better than a sandwich. Even has a better pickle. Papadillas for just $6. Better ingredients, better pizza, better than a sandwich, Papa John's.
What if I sleep bad?
Or cold?
Introducing the new Sleep Number 360 Smart Bed. Now temperature balancing, so you can sleep better together. Save up to $1,000 on the new Sleep Number 360 Smart Bed and adjustable base, plus 0% interest for 48 months. Ends Monday.
Wow, I wish I could get a deal on a smartphone, but I'm not a new customer.
Well, actually now new and existing customers can get our best smartphone deal. It's historic.
That is historic, which means I'm making history, right?
Yeah, I don't know if I'd exactly...
Wow, me, Dave Brown, existing customer who got the greatest deal in history.
Just like every other customer gets.
Oh, that's cool, too.
It's not complicated. AT&T is making history. Everyone gets our best smartphone deals, including the latest pre-orders.
It takes a young fan who was fighting his cancer journey and told me that you got what it takes, coach. You're going to win this battle.
And the Chiefs
going for it all. Touchdown.
Allen and the Bills. A special Monday edition of NFL on Fox, NFL Network, and streaming on Prime Video.
Today's game is sponsored by AT&T 5G.
The Tampa Bay defense has been coming after Aaron Rodgers all game. He has withstood the punishment.
After 7.5,
he's thrown a couple of picks. One for a pick six. Won a couple of throws later.
Hot dog.
His first game.
Former
two interceptions.
Seattle Dragons coach Jim Zorn is a lefty.
Against Carolina.
Congrats to Jim Zorn.
Starting at their 12, down by 28. And they run it.
Dirksen takes high for a ball.
Off is to the rookie A.J. Dillon, a gain of three.
That's to the Dolphins on their win.
You have to be really careful with Aaron Rodgers here in this fourth quarter and not expose him. He doesn't have Bakhtiari out there. The Tampa Bay defense is pinning their ears back and coming after him. They've got to keep Aaron Rodgers healthy.
Yeah, well, I agree. I was watching the sidelines when they came out to see if he was going to be taking the field. That says all you need to know. It's just under 12 minutes to play in the fourth quarter, and you're wondering whether Rodgers is going to still be in the game.
Quick throws, that's what they're going with, and that first run. This one good for 6 yards short of a first down, Devontae Adams.
I mean, you think about this game, Joe, for Tampa Bay, and I mean, this has been a dominant performance by them. And when is the last time?
Tony, how about negative 1.2 points?
Tampa Bay has dominated a really good opponent. I can't remember when they've done that.
How about 1.2 points on Michael Gallup or nobody?
By a lot of people, I think this is a rematch game. I think there's playoff implications here today, and I think there's a good chance that they're going to see each other again in January.
Dog, I came close to not starting the Bucs defenses.
Out across the 40 as they try to get the rookie.
Me too, dog.
A gain of 20.
But yeah, so this, assuming nothing miraculous happens here the rest of the way, this is a really great job by Tampa Bay. Now, I'm glad to see this guy. He's gotten a couple opportunities in some mop-up duty late in games when they've had leads. He's kind of getting that time now. But this guy, he is a powerful back.
Put up huge numbers at Boston College as Rodgers throws it away. 4,300 plus yards, 38 touchdowns in 3 seasons at BC. He's thick, 247 pounds. That's how he's listed, but he ran a 4.53 40 at the combine.
And look at the legs on this guy. I mean, it looks like Earl Campbell. I mean, those are tree stumps. You get in the wrong way of those things, and you're going to get hurt. After 8 innings, the score. Talk about a guy that big that has that kind of speed. Up next with I'm excited right now to see what he might do.
Here we go. They hand it to him here over the right side. Puts his head down, takes it up to the 44. Ledbetter on the stop, a gain of 3. Tomorrow night we will be there for the Chiefs and the Bills, a game that was originally scheduled for this past Thursday, and we are on the air at 4:30 Eastern, 1:30 Pacific. It's on Fox, NFL Network, and streaming on Prime Video, and I am anxious. We saw that man on the left win a Super Bowl in February. We were there in person in Miami, and now we get to see Josh Allen.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it. Great matchup. Two teams coming off tough losses. There's some urgency with them. Two guys that have arm talent that is really unique. The only guy who really compares, in my opinion, is the guy throwing right here.
And down he goes. Aaron Rodgers gets sacked again. Devin White.
Well, they bring Devin White and Levante David right up the gut. I mean, here they come, and then Jamal Williams has to make a decision on who he's going to take. And it didn't matter. I mean, whoever he takes, there's one three coming inside.
Remember Amos Zeroway?
They have. I can't say enough for the job that Todd Bowles has done, giving different looks.
Former Steelers, Raiders, and Patriots running back.
Defending that, or these third down looks.
He plays amateur soccer in New York City now.
It's really been something.
Devin White, his third tackle for a loss in the game. Scott.
Total.
Keeps Mickens inside the 20, 47-yard punt. All Aaron Rodgers could do. After that 10-0 lead, we've seen a lot of this. Shake of the head. Back to the sideline. All Buccaneers tonight.
14.
We made USAA insurance for this season and the veterans that never quit on their team. When being a fan gets tough and stretching your budget gets even tougher, our agents put in the time and legwork for you. So saving on auto insurance is easy. Here comes the
first pitch of the 44.
Saving a little extra goes a long way. USAA. What you're made of, we're made for. USAA.
That's a foul run, but he should have room.
Rush for 706. Oh, God damn it. I just sprayed ice cream all over my face. Fuck. The spoon in my cup flung and hit some ice cream. God, cunt.
My name is Henry.
Oh, fucking faggot, dude. My glasses are all sticky and...
We want to be sustainable, but when you have a truck covering over 300 miles...
God damn it. He rushed for 762 yards in 2002.
We are letting the data guide us to the best solution. It's inspiring to try to solve a problem that nobody else has solved. That's
yeah.
Super exciting. So far today, this guy is hitting everything in
sight. Yeah. I think I gotta go wash my glasses.
Somewhere. The all-new Chevy Trailblazer, making life's journey just better.
The King is calling to tell us about the 3-for-3 deal.
I get a double cheeseburger.
Fries?
Get a drink.
For only $3?
That sounds like a win-win-win situation.
Good times are calling with a 3-for-3. Order it on the BK app. Your way, way better.
As you look at the standings in the NFC South,
this was James Conner wrong in that graphic.
Tampa Bay coming out like a lion here tonight. And just taking it to the Green Bay Packers. They will
yeah, they put Conner.
4-2. That's a ground ball the other way. The early returns are indeed in. Third out, we go to the bottom of the inning. Most precincts have reported. Going into the bottom of the ninth, Tampa Bay Bucks trail by three. Are in charge here in this one. Let's go around the league. The closer, Francisco Rodriguez. The Steelers just took it to the Browns. The Titans. Also remain
undefeated.
Titans recently beat the Bills, who we will see tomorrow night at
one.
Giants and Falcons are in the win column. I don't read fast enough to figure out what the right side of the screen says. And then that comeback by the Colts as they came back on the Cincinnati Bengals. Bengals jumped out to a big lead in that one. Somebody text me and tell me what I missed.
Well, I tell you, the Cincinnati game, you know, it's interesting, Joe, because a young quarterback, a really talented guy, we had a chance to see him a few weeks ago, and I think he's really special. But for Cincinnati, you're trying to find, you know, you're trying to get that win and to just start building on something. And it takes me to this game here. And I just go back. This is a huge win for Tampa Bay. I mean, for Tom Brady, for Bruce Arians, the way in which they did it, a total team effort against a really good football team. I mean, this is something that they can definitely build on.
Here's a blitz. Brady gets hit. And as he's laying on the grass, he watches the back end of the play incomplete for Cyril Grayson.
Tom really likes Grayson. Yeah, I talked about it. He didn't even play college football. He was a track guy, but Tom really likes him, probably because he's one of the few guys who's been able to practice here over the last few weeks.
Practice?
But he really likes him. He really likes Tyler Johnson, another guy, a young player who gets to practice. But he's tried to get him involved, tried to get a deep shot to him. He can run. The Anaheim
Angels win it. I can't believe you're talking about practice. Practice?
Practice.
Talking about practice.
It's important.
It is. Always read about that. Reps. What about reps? Here's a fair catch by Darius Shepherd for a 44-yard punt. Well, a couple of vets, crafty vets, had some fun this week. Tom Brady tweeted at LeBron after LeBron won his fourth.
No, where'd he get to go? Come on, dude. I wanted to talk to him.
Superimposing the King's head.
I wanted to talk life.
Body with the four fingers up. And they had a nice little exchange on Twitter as Tim Boyle does indeed take over here at quarterback for the Green Bay Packers. And Rodgers is out for the rest of the game to protect him, if nothing else, as Dillon carries over the left side for 3 yards. Tom Brady neither confirmed nor denied during the week or on the call whether he knew it was fourth down or still thought it was third down when he threw that last pass last week at Chicago.
No, I'm not surprised. He didn't need to. I mean, I think everybody knows what happened, and, you know, it happens.
It's happened to us up here in the booth.
Yeah, we're in a different world. God forbid you if you make a mistake in today's world.
Oh, my God. Yep. Twitter comes after you.
Who's playing QB?
Now we got old Tim Boyle in the game now.
Tim Boyle.
Only attempted.
Who the fuck is Tim Boyle?
In his
career. He's our backup quarterback.
The only Boyle I know is Supervisor Patrick O'Boyle.
When you talk to the people in the organization, and this is generally the
case. I love Patrick O'Boyle.
With a backup, you know, they're generally really smart guys. They process information well. They don't need a lot of reps because they don't get them. And then they just got to be ready to come in and play in a moment's notice and do a decent enough job to where they get to keep their
job. When did that happen?
Boyle is stripped to the ball and able to get back on top. That was JPP. This defense, they're not pulling anybody out of the ball game. They're going to keep riding this momentum, and big number 90 got in there and knocked it away.
Oh, no, that wasn't O'Boyle.
19th career forced fumble.
That was before O'Boyle was, or that was before the real O'Boyle actor. But it was a different, position. It was a different guy in the company. It wasn't the supervisor. Because the supervisor was still working there. But I don't remember what position it was. Yes, that position that he filled was in the same office as the supervisor in future episodes.
First of all, Scott came in as Mickens returns it, gets to 31 maybe. Scott came in with seven punts.
He's playing quarterback for the Bucks.
He hadn't punted the ball enough to even get on the official stats around the league. He's punted seven times within this game.
Is that Blaine Gabbert?
And he is showing a lot of knee. Old J.K. Scott.
Well, he'll be on a different list come Monday morning, and it'll be the injury report because that leg's going to be hurting, right? He's had to use it a little bit.
Never seen that kind of a gap between the top of the socks and the bottom of the.